Of course it's a couple of days after the fight, man.
What are we at, Saturday?
One of the days, Saturday, 2 days after the fight. I can't stay home, son.
And here we go.
Yes.
We're checking it here. Gleason's Gym, Brooklyn, New York. We got in front of us Mikkel Lespierre, Shawn Cameron, Don Saxby. A couple days out from the fight, as Cam just informed everybody, but that doesn't mean we're not going to talk about the fight. And through the magic of video, we're going to be able to take y'all back through the fight, through this video. Sometimes you got to live in the past a little bit, then you move forward. But that's what I'm saying. Wax on, wax off is what we're doing in this video. So first, I'm going to put it on Don so we get a little bit of intelligence put on this video. Don, I'm going to put it on you first. Talk to me a little bit about the fight on Thursday with Cam and you know what you thought about his performance.
I thought his performance was pretty good. You know, he used his jab that we put a lot of emphasis on in training, you know, because he wasn't using his jab at some point, but for some reason, we came out the locker room, he brought the jab with him. And, you know, that was one of the reasons the fight was so much easier. But, you know, it was good. We expected him to go to the body and do the things that he normally do. But he a hater. I see him on the side. So, well, overall, I like his performance. I did. I like his performance. I like his body work, his composure, his neatness in there. How he knew what he was doing. So, you know, no complaints. Of course, I would have liked to see the jab a little more, but hey, half a loaf is better than none. So I take it. You just steadily improving. That's it.
Absolutely.
Now, that's no more, no less.
Now, Cam, before I put you on, I'm going to throw it over to Mick. Mick, from your perspective and somebody that's also in your working with Cam every day, what were your thoughts on Cam's performance?
Like I said, you know, like Don said, Why are you stuttering? Like Don said, you know, he did what he had to do. He used his jab. You know, I'm impressed with his composure and the fact that he brought his jab out the locker room.
Yes.
You know, and so I'm just happy he got to win because, you know, it's a steadily improving effort, you know, every time out when you get in that ring. As long as, you know, he didn't have an easy opponent in front of him. He had tough, you know, journeyman, guys with 22 fights.
No doubt about it. Now, Cam, I know you don't like being put on the spot, but I'm going to ask you what you felt about your own performance out there. Just how the night felt overall.
First of all, man, I don't understand why both of them jumping me, talking crazy about me, he brought his jab out the locker room.
Get out of the way with that.
I thought it was okay. I thought the whole atmosphere, I was really prepared for this fight, so, you know, it really wasn't no nerves. I mean, I probably was like a little rusty because I haven't been really that active, but
since me.
Right. Oh no.
Leave me alone, bitch. Damn.
But all in all, I thought it was good. Dude was tough. I really wanted to stop him, but after like going to the body a couple times and breaking him down, and I hit him clean a couple times, and he was like, "My guy, can't beat. We're just gonna shake it up." I mean, I could go all night, but after like a couple rounds and I hit him clean with some good shots, I'm like, he ain't going, all right, cool, you just gonna shake it up. I could have boxed a little bit more and moved a little bit more, but I, you know, my stupid ass, I elected to stay in the pocket because I wanted it to be a little bit physical, you know what I'm saying? Overall, I'm okay. Out of 10, I'd probably like say, I give myself like a 6.5 or maybe even a 7, which is really good. So I'm back here 2 days after. I'm back working on what I need to work on to the next, you know?
No doubt. Now, Don, we came back in the gym already. 2 days after the fight, obviously, all focus is now set on the next date and everything and going forward. But, you know, getting Cam back in and getting him active, obviously, Mick's going to be active this year as well. You know, what are some of the prospects you're kind of hoping for with Cam?
Are we looking at Showbox? Hopefully. I like him. That was his first 6 pounds, so I would like 2 more 6s, you know, that would be over 10 fights. Like, I wanted 6 4s and 4 6s. So the numbers, you know, they're pretty good. Then right after that, you know, from the managers, when I gathered from the managers, they said we're going to be on Showbox. You know, we just looking for bigger and better things with Cam. That's it. He's back in the gym. We know, everybody knows he's a gym rat. He's back in the gym 2 days after the fight. Most guys will take a week off or whatever. He's right back in the gym. And I think really because he's probably just bored.
Yeah, you know what I mean? I ain't got nothing better than hanging out with Junior McMahon. On a Saturday.
He's at home stressing his mom's out, so I know she's glad he's gone.
Yeah, she kicked me out of the house, getting out the way.
Yeah, but like I said, I like his performance. I did like his performance. He's saying he can only get better. He can only get better. And I'm sure it shot him up mentally and
confidence.
Much more confidence. Not fighting since May. And, you know, from as far as I'm concerned, this fight was the best fight of the night. Because you know, you had guys out there. Not to knock them, but they were fighting guys they should have got rid of. They were going the distance with them. We went the distance with a guy, with this guy on Calzada. But from what I heard previously about Calzada, that two of the guys turned him down, which one of the guys fought that night. I'm not going to name any names. One of the guys, you know, they turned him down. But we took him, just to prove a point. You know, so, you know, he's improving. He is. He's improving.
Absolutely. Now, Mick, you know, once again, you know, coming from your perspective and everything, somebody's in here every day with Cam, and, you know, the whole atmosphere the other night was really live whenever Cam got in there. But talk to us a little bit about, you know, just the whole atmosphere and everything, what was going on outside the ring.
Well, you know, Cam has a big following. You know, people follow him. They attract his personality.
The shenanigans.
Just say what it is.
You know, so they show him support. You know what I'm saying? And that's basically what it was. It's a support system coming to, you know, show support. You know, everybody wants to see him do well. You know, so that's basically what it was. You know, you had me, our friends, our intermediate friends. You have the people just off of social media. You know what I'm saying? That just comes to see him do his thing. And it was a good atmosphere. To me, I think he had the most supporters there. You know what I'm saying?
So,
absolutely did.
I mean,
this is what we do.
So it's you know, it's not really. It was a crazy atmosphere. Well, just to begin with, you know what I'm saying, and it was a great fight.
Hey, Cam, I know that, you know, all the support and all the love, something that actually, it does mean a lot to you. Talk to me a little bit about, you know, just all that support that, you know, that you get from everybody and the loyalty you have, you know, obviously from these two people right here.
Is really satisfying, you know? Because these people don't know me from nowhere. Now, personally, I ain't shit. I just started boxing not so long ago, and I just, you know, I mean, I work hard, of course, and a lot of times people see that, and they appreciate it. Appreciate and respect that. And it means a lot when people that you don't even know, you know, they're interested in to see what's going to happen next, and they follow you. They follow your career, and they follow everything, and they see the progression, you know what I'm saying? That in itself is major. It's worth more than, it ain't worth more than the money, but it's up there. Because it's stuff like that that'll make me want to just perform better and just keep going and be more consistent. Like, you know what I'm saying? It really fuels my fire and it keeps me going. That's it.
No doubt. Now, I kind of let each of y'all touch on this a little bit, but, you know, Don, speaking with Cam, you know, what kind of closing comments you have or what kind of message you have out there for the supporters and maybe those people that might be, think Cam ain't what, you know, what he is.
It's all right, you know. Keep supporting them, you know. The ones that love us, we appreciate you. The ones that hate us, we appreciate you too, because it just gives us that much more motivation to keep doing what we do. You know, we came a long way. You know what I mean? And I know where he came from, because I remember starting with him. And, you know, we just riding this wave, and we're not letting him drown. We're just going to keep pushing. That's it. We're trying to keep pushing.
How about you, Mick?
Same thing. You know, the supporters, we love the supporters. Haters give us more motivation to do even surpass our expectations. You know what I'm saying? That's what drives us to do well. You know? That's life in general.
Go ahead and take us home, Cam.
Listen, hating here, loving here don't matter. You know, I'm. A lot of people don't get these opportunities, man. And once I get the opportunity to do some shit, I'm gonna put this shit in a chokehold, you understand me?
Absolutely.
I appreciate all the people that support me. Everybody. I don't think I'm better than nobody. Like I said, I don't really think I ain't shit. I'm just a motherfucker that work hard and go out there and just do my best, and a lot of people that admire that. So I really do appreciate the people that appreciate me. You know what I'm saying?
People that hate me, that's cool.
Fuck y'all.
But we still gonna work.
At the end of the day, man, I'm not even gonna stop. It's just on to the next. You know what I mean? On to the next. I'm looking. Once I get the ball rolling, I don't want to stop. I'm out there running in the blizzard. The other night, we had a blizzard, and the mayor's like, "Yo,
okay.
Why you supposed to be out here after 11
o'clock? What? Man, fighting in 2 days? What are you talking about? You went home canoodling right now, dogs. Get out of my way.
Let me get this work, man. You know what I mean? We're working. Me and McNasty and everybody, my whole team.
You know, almost left out some. We want to thank Brian Gilligan and Vinny Scarpino. Appreciate you guys.
Everybody. Brian, Vinny, Lou for giving me the shot.
Amy,
everybody that came around. The whole team, son. Like, I really can't just name one person. It's like so many people that are going, but they follow because they see what's going on and they like and appreciate it. And that's just fuel right there in itself to keep going.
You know, so I promise to try to keep giving you guys good fights. That's it. We're gonna come out there and give our best.
Always.
That's all we can ask.
I'll give you 110. Yeah. You give me the shot, I'm out there.
You know I know.
You know I know, dogs. Like, you know I know, son. I'm out there where ain't nobody else out there. You know what I'm saying? Man, you know my story. I'm not supposed to be here. Dogs, I'm not supposed to be here. I'm not supposed to be doing none of this shit. Life here, you fucking lemons, you make lemonade and or take shots. Fuck it, keep going. You're dead serious. And that's what it is, man. So we're gonna keep going. Bottom line, we could talk all day, but just watch. You know what I mean?
You're gonna see. Show us it.
There it is, right there. But we'll go ahead and close it out on that note. But Mick, Cam, Don, as always, our side over here at Resolution Sports, we always appreciate your time with us and your hospitality. And I just want to thank y'all for spending a little bit of time with us.
The support is greatly appreciated, man. The support is greatly appreciated. A lot of people, you know what I mean? You didn't have to come in and do this. You know what I'm saying? Like, I really appreciate it. Regardless of all the shenanigans and all that, like, I appreciate it. I appreciate you and everybody's support. You know what I mean? People bought tickets. They didn't have to buy them tickets to come out. If you see the atmosphere and everybody bugging out, they didn't have to do that. I didn't put a gun to your head and say, yo, you gotta come to my fight.
I thought that's why they called you Killa.
$500 ticket.
Listen, the book bag.
I was working the corner.
This is what we're gonna do? In the Philly
No, this is what we're gonna do.
Hey, man, get on, son. We out of here, man. Oh, yeah, you really looking too. Nah, for real. Appreciate it. Everything is appreciated, and we're just gonna keep going.
No doubt. Yeah, love is love.
You'll see. We could talk all day, but you'll see.
There it is right there. All right, we're going to close it out on that note. Until next time, we out.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, after six rounds of action here at Baby Kings, we go to the judges' scorecards. All three judges, Alan Nace, John Potere, and John Vasily scored this bout identically, 58-56. All three for your winner by unanimous decision. He's still undefeated.
Thank you.